so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watch, were so gallantly streaming.
Saints Prophetess Dawn O'Brien, Servant of the Lord with Dawn's Heartfelt Corner here. Happy New Year, everyone. We're in the new year, and I believe this is going to be a good year for us. But, you know, we're also going to go through things in this new year. But there are those that have been walking with God daily, and they've been waiting. This is your year. Do you hear me? This is your year. I believe that with all my heart. 2018 is our year. And, we've got a lot to talk about today. You know, I need to just say it because this has been coming to me that, you know, this is my own opinion, okay? I believe that that they waited, the government and everything with, you know, we've been hearing about things that are happening. I believe there are people that know things are going to happen, and they waited till after the holidays. That's what I'm saying. I believe we're going to see something happen in this year. Now, we're going to go through trials and that, but I believe we're going to see greater miracles. This is the greatest year for us Christians that are walking with the Lord. I really believe God is going to want to use you and use me in these last days before Jesus comes back. Let's pray. Let's invite the Holy Spirit. We've got more worship, but I've got to tell you something, Saints. I mean, it's not funny, but, you know, God has a way of speaking, and he says something to me. Yesterday afternoon, I did stunning for like 2 hours, and I'm going to share with you what God was showing me. And I mean, it was like, wow. I mean, he's giving me more revelation and knowledge, you know, and he don't give me no blessing message. I'm going to tell you right now, that's not the what God is giving me. You know, I was noticing, and we're going to talk about, you know, where people have come up with this New Year's resolution, and then they come up with all these declarations for the new year. That's kind of like a resolution, you know. When we come up, oh, this year it's going to be this, and this is going to be that. We hear it every year. Well, you know, we're going to talk about this. I got to share this with you. Well, let's pray. I don't want to get going on that. Let's pray. Let's worship some more, and then we're going to talk. So, Holy Spirit, we welcome you here. What you're wanting me to say, Father, I yield myself to you, precious Holy Spirit. I ask you to speak through me slowly and clearly, Lord, so that the people can hear and understand what it is you're wanting me to say, Father. Lord, we thank you for this day. This is the day you and me will rejoice and be glad in it, Lord. This is a new year. I know people had to go back to work. Father, it's hard for them. That's because their eyes are on their holidays and on their Christmas and New Year, and it came and went. But our eyes are upon you, Lord Jesus. You're our hope. You're our strength for each new day. You're what helps us get out of that bed every day, Lord. If it wasn't for you, Lord, we couldn't go on, Lord. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you for your grace. We thank you, Lord, for helping us, Lord. We love you. We praise you. We lift your name up on high. We exalt you, Father. May your presence and glory fill this place. Touch your people, Lord, as I'm talking, Lord. We just welcome you here right on this Facebook page, Father. May you be glorified in all we say and all we do. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. All right, we're going to worship some more because he lives. Jesus lives. We can face tomorrow. That's right. Praise him.
God sent his son. They called him Jesus.
My voice.
He came to love. Heal and forgive. He lived and died to buy my part.
Amen. Jesus lives.
An empty grave is there. Savior lives.
Praise him.
Because he lives, I can face tomorrow.
We can face tomorrow because Jesus lives.
Because he lives, all fear is gone.
Of your love forever. Let's sing of Jesus' love. Mm-hmm. Amen. Praise him. We love you, Lord. We love you. Oh, Lord, we love you.
Over the mountains and the sea, your river runs with love for me. And I will open up my heart and let the healer set me free. I'm happy to be in the truth, and I will daily lift my hands. For I will always sing of when your love came down, yeah. I could sing. I could sing your love.
Love. He can sing of your love forever,
Lord.
I love you.
Over the mountains and the sea, your river runs with love for me, and I will open up my heart and let the healer set me free. I'm happy to be in the truth, and I will daily lift my hands, for I will always sing of when your love came down.
All right, let's bless the Lord this morning. Bless him, saints. Bless you, Lord. He's here. The Holy Spirit's here.
I will bless the Lord and give
Jehovah. If you're listening to me, this worship right now, I'm going to play a few songs on healing. Maybe you're sick in body. Just believe for your healing wherever you're at. You know, even when God gets ready to use me, I can't do anything. I'm just a vessel just like you are, you know. We're here to let God use us, but we can't do anything. God is going to literally, I really feel this, he's going to just heal people like that. So let these songs minister to you.
I am the God that healeth thee. I am the Lord, your healer. I sent my word and healed your disease. I am the Lord, your healer.
Let your people hear you, Lord.
I am the God
God's name is more powerful than any disease you can name tonight. You might have received a horrible report from the doctors and told you your disease is incurable. But you know what? There's hope tonight.
Yes, there's hope.
There is hope because God's promised that He would heal us. I want you to put His word on your lips tonight. Sing His word back to Him. And see if His name isn't more powerful than cancer, than heart disease, or any disease that you can name tonight.
Amen. He's more powerful. Jesus.
He's your healer.
Hallelujah.
Sing it to Him. You are the God that healeth me.
You are the God
that healeth me.
That healeth me.
You are the Lord, my healer. You sent your word and you healed my disease. You are the Lord, my healer.
Yes.
You are the God.
You are the God
that healeth me.
That healeth me.
Oh, you are the Lord.
You are the Lord. You sent your word and you healed my disease. You are the Lord, my healer. You sent your word and you healed my disease. You are the Lord, my healer. You sent your word and you healed my disease. You are the Lord, my healer.
Let's invite the Holy Spirit. Going. 1 minute, it's not going. We were not to play it. It's not going. That's weird. There it goes.
Lift your hands and ask Him to fill you tonight, saints. I will open rivers in high places, fountains in the midst of the valleys. I will make the wilderness a pool of water and the dry land springs of water.
Holy Spirit, Thou art welcome.
Thou art welcome here. Creation shows the power of God, His glory all around. And those who see stand in awe
for miracles abound.
For miracles abound.
Lift those hands and sing it with us.
I believe in miracles. I see souls set free.
Worship of saints.
Miraculous. The changing one. Redeemed. Calvary. I see the lily push its way through the stubborn stars.
Miracles. One more. Believe for your miracle today.
Touch.
Will cleanse you and make your life.
around your people.
If by faith you reach out to him, he will meet your every need. He will respond to the cry in your heart. He will touch you and set you free.
Yes. Rise and be. Yes, be healed. Name Jesus. Touch your people.
Let faith
arise
in your soul.
Rise and be healed. In the name of Jesus. He will touch
you. He will cleanse you. And make your life whole. He will touch you.
Yes.
And make your life whole.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Rise and be healed.
Amen. Yes. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise Him, saints. I want to pray for all of you. You're sick in body today and you're believing for God to heal. You know, God can do anything. This is the season of miracles, saints. I do believe we're going to see miracles. They're on the edge here. We're waiting for God. So if you're needing a miracle, let's agree, saints. Let's pray and agree. Connect our faith and believe. Father, I pray for everyone that is on here right now, that is listening to me right now, Lord, that is believing for a miracle in their body, Lord. We're wanting to see your miracles, Lord. This is the season, oh God. Father, we connect our faith and we believe, Father. I pray for your people, Lord, and I speak health and healing over them right now in Jesus' name, from the top of their head to the soles of their feet. Be healed in the name of Jesus. Be healed, whatever your sickness is. Believe and have faith. Don't doubt. Don't give up. In Jesus' name, we claim that and believe that for your people right now. Amen, amen. Just believe and have faith. Don't give up. I believe we're about to see God move in such a powerful way. So we have to continue to have faith. What is faith? Faith is some things hoped for but yet not seen. No, we don't see it yet. No, I haven't seen God do anything yet, but it's coming. It's coming, saints. We have to continue to believe and have faith. Now, I'm going to share some words with you. Let me see if I should do this first or give you news. You know, I don't want to forget. I got a few things I want to talk to you about here. And I don't talk much about news. I just touch on it. For those that are listening on Facebook, you know, you can go to our YouTube page. If you're not a subscriber and you want to set up a page, maybe you don't have one. There are those that can set up a page and you can listen to our videos on there. I place more on there and I do place them on Facebook. As I get busier, I don't know what's going to happen in the future. I take one day at a time. This is my platform right now. Facebook and YouTube is a platform that God has places on. Daniel will be speaking to him. He's taking care of our roommate right now. He helps me in vaccines. But soon, Daniel and I will be together speaking. I believe that. We're waiting on the Lord. All right, let me share some news with you here. Now, let me see if I can pull it up. I told you, I have problems sometimes with these links here. Let me close this one out here. All right, I don't know if you heard about this. Let me see if I can pull it up here. It's giving me a lot of problems. Kim warns of Washington of a nuclear butt on the desk. Did you hear about that? Kim warns Washington. After issuing threats to the United States in the New Year's message, Kim Jong-un offered some hope of a thaw in relations with South Korea, saying Pyongyang is open to talks while wishing success for the 2018 Pyeongchang Winter Olympics, okay? Now, this is what I said. This is my own opinion. I said, I believe Kim Jong-un is trying to make peace with South Korea, those on the border, because they're all going to turn on the United States. That's what I believe. I believe that's what they're trying to do, because why all of a sudden are they trying to make peace? All right? But he's letting us know that the button's right on his desk, so he can hit it at any time. He's a cucky. I don't want to say it, but, you know, he's cucky. But I know God is in control. You know, we got to deal with these demons in the last days, these people that have devils in them. All right? So this is why I said, you cannot trust China, Russia, or any of our so-called friends. Okay, they're not friends. I'm going to tell you right now. They are not our friends, because they're not our friends. They're our enemies. They want South Korea on their side. No, we can't trust in them. You know, we need to pray for our nation. We need to pray for President Donald Trump and in the Trump administration. You know, he gets on the phone. He talks to Russia, talks to China, trying to put sanctions on North Korea. I'm going to tell you right now. They're not going to sit in between and let this war go on, all right? They're not going to do that. And Russia, we've got sanctions on them. So I'm going to tell you right now, we can't trust anyone. They all hate the United States, all right? Iran, we're not going to get into that. I don't talk much about news. I just touch on it. All right. Then I want to share this with you. I don't know if you heard about this. Mudslide danger replaces a fire threat in Southern California. I'm reading from a CNN report here. I'm just going to touch on this down here. Let me see if I can pull it up here. A lady said something here. Hold on one second. Let me see if I can get to it. Let me find it. She said, here she goes. The residents of these communities are well aware that several miles away from the lowest edge of the Thomas Fire Line, a chain reaction flood is possible. That's what they're saying, because they're saying since they're now having mudslide danger, so they're saying that they could have a flood, okay? And this lady says it's just too much to handle after everything that's happened, she said, pushing her child in a stroller on a walk with her mother. Her home stands, although it reeked of the Thomas Fire gangling, calling card, oppressive smoke. I just feel bad for people who lost their homes, she said. They shouldn't have to handle anymore, is what she said. Okay? And I just want to say, and I'm not no gloom and doom preacher. I'm just going to tell you, get ready for more. Because, yes, we're going to go through a lot more in these last days. You know, I know people don't want to hear that. But I'm not going to sugarcoat it and give you a message that tickles your ears. Because we're going to go through trouble. In fact, in a minute, I'm going to tell you what God said to me. All right, let me pull this up here. Let's look at these earthquakes real quick. Because I always keep track of them. Give me a link so you can check it out, too. There was a 2.3 just a little while ago in Alaska. Let me pull it up here. Get the latest. It always changes when we get another earthquake. All right, that was 23 minutes ago, the one in Alaska. All right, we still got small storms going on in California. South Fiji Islands is getting some over in Australia. 5.9, I don't know if that was three of them, 119 minutes ago. Montana had a 1.5 2 hours ago. 3.3 in Texas, that was 3 hours ago. They transfer when it hits one side, it goes to the other side. I don't know much about it. Dutch Sense knows more about it. He keeps up on all those earthquakes. He's really good. He knows when it's going to happen. So we appreciate him for reporting. All right. Let's see. 4.7 in Philippines 4 hours ago. And then a 4.6 4 hours ago. Again, in Philippines. California still getting the small swarms. 2.3 in California. Pinnacles 6 hours ago. 4.4 in Japan. That was 6 hours ago. 2.0 in Alaska 6 hours ago. Tennessee had one 2.1 7 hours ago. 4.6 in San Francisco, Del Mar, Mexico, 4.6 7 hours ago. And then Nicaragua had one 4.6 7 hours ago. San Martin, California, 1.8 7 hours ago. Dominican Republic, 3.5 7 hours ago. I'm not sharing all of these with you. Montana, 1.3 8 hours ago. Small swarms in Nevada, California. Vanuatu, 5.0 and 5.2. That was 8 hours ago. 2.8 again in Pinnacles, California. Small swarms going along here in the 2.2s in California. Some I know the USGS is downgrading. I'm hearing that. Remember, I told you, Dutch sense said the lava rocks, the volcanoes are erupting underneath in the ocean, and nobody's saying anything about it. Well, Los California had a 2.2 10 hours ago, Tennessee a 0.4, a small one, 11 hours ago, and a 1.3 11 hours ago. Alaska again is having some, and Nevada 1.1 11 hours ago, 4.6 Tonga. 11 hours old. I mean, these are happening every few minutes. That's why we can't go by what the economy's doing. I'm going to tell you right now. I mean, we've seen the way those wildfires, how much it's cost billions of dollars, all right? But we're not talking about that, okay? We're hardly even talking about that. Volcano Hawaii, 1.7, 11 hours ago. 5.1 in Greece, 12 hours ago. Puerto Rico had a few, 3.4, 12 hours ago. Tom's Place, California, small storm, 0.8, 2.5 in Olaka, California, 13 hours ago. All right, I think that's it. Small storms in California are going on, all right? So that's what's happening with the earthquakes. But you can keep a track of that. I've given you the link yourself so you can go on it, all right? All right, let me give you these words. These encouraging words, then we're going to get into what we're going to talk about. All right, I'm going to read you yesterday's. It wasn't on here yesterday. But Bill Burns said this for yesterday. Come and walk with me. If you walk with me, you will learn of my ways. The ways that have been hard for you to find in the past. If you will walk with me. Excuse me. I'm going to go drink. My throat is getting dry. I pray God heal me of this asthma. It's terrible. And more I get a little cool weather here in Florida. It's not too bad, though. They get cold, but I don't run the heat. I don't like to run the heat because it gets all stuffy and hot. I got my fan going in the back. Maybe it's my Italian. I'm hot-blooded, so I got the fan going in the back. Well, I got a sweater on, but I get the fan going. All right. Bill Burns said this, if you walk with me, you will become one with me, and if you become one with me, then you will know the way in which you should go. You will be able to receive all that I will reveal in this season. If you come with me on this journey, you'll be blessed beyond measure. So come, says the Lord. Marsha Burns said this, simplicity is a place of strength. See, God wants us to be simple, all right? When things get too When things get too complicated, you'll lose concentration and you could even lose sight of purpose. I'm just going to stop for a minute. When you hear me not pronouncing real good, and it's because I was in a car accident. For those that don't know, in 2000, I had brain surgery, almost died. I'm a walking miracle. So, you know, I squint and I don't see very good. I had laser surgery, but I wear glasses now to see far away. And that, but I'll stutter my words. I can't get them out because of my car. You can go on our website, www.dawn's heartfelt corner, and you can read my whole testimony. But I should have been dead. I was hit by a drunk driver that almost killed me. I'm a walking miracle. God is good. I was on my way to church, and you can read the whole testimony. All right, let me get back to this. So she's talking about being simple. When things get too complex, you lose concentration, and you could even lose sight of purpose. Just get down to the basics, the essence of who you are and what you must do to express yourself honestly, clearly, and understandably. Refuse to allow things in your life to get too complex or tangled, says the Lord. Create me, Psalm 51:10, create me a clean heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me. Prophet Russ said this, the Father says today that this is your season of enrichment and fortifying you and strengthening you for the campaign of total victory unfolding for you even now. Amen. There are those I know waiting. This is your time this year. I really, truly believe that. Step forward with feet shod with my good news. The outcome is assured. Your part is to walk out what I've already provided for and give evidence of my goodness in the land of the living. There are triumphs coming to you right now for the express purpose of having crowns to cast at my feet. Worship and warfare involve conquest and the spoiling of the enemy. You will lay hold of the spoil of the enemy and bring captives forth to new liberty and victory by your word and by your testimony. Let the shout of triumph be in your mouth this day, says the Father. All things are new. The old has passed away, no more to impede or hinder you in any manner. Yesterday, last week, last month, last year is rolled up as a scroll and delivered into the archives of heaven. Your focus is to be on your now and what I'm bringing about of my graciousness and my favor in your life and in your situation. Reach out by your obedience to lay hold of all that I have accorded you. The bounty of heaven is at your disposal. The finished work of Calvary is working in your behalf. My yes and amen are set at your side, willing you to move forward in faith, knowing as you yield fully to my purpose, my plan, and my threat that everything you say and do will be as effective as if I said it or did it. Amen. Now, I'm just going to read you Marsha Burns for today. She said, if you have questions about how to proceed and there are complexities involved in your decision-making process, however, I will give you wisdom and guidance. If you ask, and that is so true, when you go to the Lord, He will give you wisdom and direction and guidance for what's ahead, what you need to do for that day. Ask in complete assurance that I will impart supernatural insights that will take you where you need to go, says the Lord. I hear and answer the prayer of faith. James 1:5. If any of you lacks wisdom, let him ask of God who gives to all liberally and without reproach, and it will be given to them. Amen. All right, so thank you, Prophet Russ and Bill Burns and Marsha Burns. Praise the Lord. Now, I'm going to share this word with you because I felt led to that. I really enjoyed this word this morning. I don't know if you get the daily bread sent to you, but I get it in my inbox. I get it also sent to me, I believe, too. But I'm going to read you a scripture, and then I'm going to read this word, and I really like it. It's talking about pressing on. But I want to read you first Philippians 3. I'm going to read the whole chapter. You know, it's very important that we read scripture, you know, so that we know what the Bible says. You know, we don't hear enough of it. My people die for lack of knowledge. So we need to be reading and testing what we're listening to. And we're going to talk about some things today because there's a lot of spoken words that are being spoken that you and I aren't testing. And we're just going, oh, good message. It's tickling our ears. All right, we need to make sure we're testing it and making sure it lines up with the Word of God. All right, so I'm going to read you Philippians 3. And now, my brothers and sisters, be filled with joy in the Lord. It is no trouble for me to write the same things to you again. I want to be sure that you are prepared. Be careful of the dogs, verse 2. Those men whose work does only harm. They want to cut on everyone who isn't circumcised. But we are the ones who have the true circumcision. We who worship God through His Spirit. We don't trust in ourselves or anything we can do. We take pride only in Christ Jesus. Verse 4, even if I'm able to trust in myself, still I don't do that. He said, if anyone else thinks they have a reason to trust in themselves, I lost my place. They should know that I have a greater reason for doing so. Verse 5, I was circumcised on the 8th day, he said, after my birth. I'm from the people of Israel and the tribe of Benjamin. I'm a true Jew, and so were my parents. The law was very important to me. That is why I became a Pharisee. I was so eager to defend my religion, he said, that I persecuted the church. And no one could find fault with the way I obeyed the law of Moses. So I'm reading to you from the easy-to-read version so that you understand. Verse 7, at one time, all these things were important to me, he says. Okay? Then it goes on to say, but because of Christ, I decided that they are worth nothing. All right? He says in verse 8, not only these things, but now I think that all things are worth nothing compared with the greatness of knowing Christ Jesus, my Lord. See, all this other stuff is rubbish. It's not important. All right, it goes on to say, because of Christ, I lost all these things, and now I know that they are worthless trash. See, nothing in this life matters. I told you, don't hold on to material things. The only thing that you can hold on to is Christ. Everything else is going to go in this life. All I want now is Christ, he says. First, I want to belong to him. In Christ, I am right with God, but my being right does not come from following the law, he says. Verse 10, all I want is to know Christ and the power that raised him from the dead. I want to share in his sufferings and be like him even in his death. Then, verse 11, then there is hope that I myself will somehow be raised from death. And then he goes on, trying to reach the goal. I don't mean that I'm exactly what God wants me to be. I've not yet reached that goal. None of us have. We're changing from glory to glory. But he says, I continue trying to reach it and make it mine. See, we're to strive to be like Christ. That's what Christ Jesus wants me to do, he says. It is the reason he made me his. Verse 13, brothers and sisters, I know that I still have a long way to go. But there is one thing I do. I love this. I forget what is in the past, and I try as hard as I can to reach the goal before me. That's why we can't go by what's happened in the past. Don't go to your past. Don't let the enemy whisper in your ear, oh, look at your past. Look what you did. You know, because if you do, you're not going to press forward into the things that God has for you. This is a new day. I'm done. This is a new year. All right? So God's got new things for you and for me. Maybe you're listening to me and you don't know Christ. You've never given him your heart and life. You know, maybe you've had a bad past. Maybe you went through a bad divorce. You don't know the Lord. You know, you could be going through a lot of things. Maybe you lost a child. Maybe you lost a loved one, a father, a mother, you know. And maybe you're upset with God about something. And you're, you know, if you're trying to compare yourself to Christians, don't do that. Because we're not perfect. We're far from perfect. God is changing all of us from glory to glory. You know, but this is the time period. You need to give your heart and life to Christ. This is a new year. Why not start brand new this year? Why not give your heart and life to Christ? You know, this is a new year. You want to be ready. You know things are happening. You're seeing things happen. Maybe you're a little frightened. You don't have to be. God is in control. You don't need to worry about what's going to happen tomorrow. You know, you listen to the news and you see things are happening and you're getting anxious, nervous, stressed. You don't have to be. God is in control. He is what holds the future. Jesus is our hope. Without Christ, we have no hope. You know, we're living every day for nothing. I'm going to tell you right now, get up, go to bed, get up, go to work, go to bed. You know, it's the same thing day in, day out. If you don't know Christ, there is no hope. All right? You need to give your heart and life to Christ. You need to do it now. Maybe you're listening to me. Let's pray. If you don't know Christ, I want you to pray with me. I want you to pray and believe it, not saying it out of fear, because you want to make a new start. You want to go in the right direction. You're tired of going the wrong direction. You've been doing things and they're not working out for you. Well, they're not going to. They're not going to work out until you give your heart and life to Christ. Now, I'm not saying everything's going to be all rosy and you're not going to have any problems, because Daniel and I have had things. But you know what? I'm glad God disciplines and puts us through things, because that means he loves us. So if God allows you to go through things, it's because he loves you. You're his children. If you're legitimate and you weren't his child, he wouldn't be disciplining. He's disciplining you now so that you'll share in his holiness and righteousness later. Okay, he's coming back for a bride without spot or wrinkle. Not everyone's going to go to heaven. I'm going to tell you right now, not everyone will go to heaven. All right, we don't talk about that. There's a heaven and there's a hell. Okay, if you don't know Christ, I'm just going to say, you're going to go to hell. I know we don't come out and say it, but that's what's going to happen. For those that do not want to give their heart and life to Christ, they're not going to spend eternity with the Lord in heaven. So you need to give your heart and life to the Lord now. But don't say it out of fear. Say it because you're ready. You're ready to make a new start. You want to see change in your life. Well, the first thing is to pray and accept Christ. That's the first step. And then you daily spend time with the Lord. And, you know, God's the one that shows you. He leads you. You know, if you're not So on our Facebook, go ahead and send us a friend request. Subscribe to our YouTube. Let Daniel and I in this ministry, Don Tarpon, mentor you, help train you up to be all that God wants you to be, so that you can be strong in the Lord, so that you can help somebody else out, and you can lead them to the Lord. That's what it's all about. We're to share the gospel, share the love of Christ, bring others to the Lord. If you don't know Him, let's pray today. Let's make 2018 a brand new year. Bow your head with me and just repeat this prayer. Say, Dear Jesus, I am a sinner. Forgive me of my sins. Cleanse me and wash me in your blood. Come into my heart and save me. I believe you died for me, Jesus, to give me eternal life. I receive you now, Jesus, as my Lord and Savior. Amen, amen. Praise the Lord. Go share the good news with someone. Go tell them what Christ has just done for you. This is the happiest day of your life. I'm going to tell you right now, nothing in life matters. But when a soul comes to Christ, the angels are rejoiced, so are we. Go ahead and write us a letter. The address is up on the screen. We'd love to hear if God has just saved you, done a miracle in your life, healed you, whatever it is. God gets the glory. We give Jesus the praise, honor, and glory. So write us today. All right, let me get back to this. All right, I'm reading you in Philippians 3. We're talking about Paul. He said, I don't mean that I'm exactly what God wants me to be. I have not yet reached that goal, but I continue trying to reach it and make it mine. That's what Christ Jesus wants me to do. It is the reason He made me His. Verse 13, brothers and sisters, I know that I still have a long way to go, but there is one thing I do. Forget what is in the past and try as hard as I can to reach the goal before me. Verse 14, I keep running hard toward the finish line to get the prize that is mine, because God has called me through Christ Jesus to the life up there in heaven. See, we can't give up. It's not how you start the race. It's how you finish. You've got to finish this race, all right? Verse 15, all of us who have grown to be spiritually mature should think this way too, and if there is any of this that you don't agree with, God will make it clear to you. But we should continue following the truth we already have. See, there's going to be a lot of people in these last days that are going to walk away, but they're not going to listen to truth. And we're already seeing that now. But they're going to go where their itchy ears want to go because they don't want to hear this type of teaching. All right? We're going to see a great falling away. Verse 17, brothers and sisters, join together in following my example. Also learn by watching those who are living the way we showed you. Verse 18, there are many who live like enemies of the cross of Christ. I've often told you about them, and it makes me cry to tell you about them now. Verse 19, the way they live is leading them to destruction. They have replaced God with their own desires, and we're seeing that. God doesn't want us to love the world. Okay, because I'm going to tell you right now, when He comes, we can't be like Lot's wife and looking back wanting to say, no, we got to let it go. We can't be tied to those things. Yes, we use them while we're here, but we're not to be tied. That's not to be number one in our life. Jesus needs to be number one. All right? They have replaced God with their own desires. They do shameful things, and they are proud of what they do. They think only about earthly things. All right? Verse 20, but the government that rules us is in heaven. We are waiting for our Savior. That's right. We're waiting for Jesus to come and get us out of here. The Lord Jesus Christ to come from there. Verse 21, He will change our humble bodies and make them like His own glorious body. Amen. Christ can do this by His power with which He is able to rule everything. I wanted to read that. Now I want to read you this word that I got from Our Daily Bread. Called Pressing On. I press on toward the goal and win the prize. Philippians 3:14. As I walked past an outside wall of the office building where I work, I was amazed to see a beautiful flower growing up through a crack between concrete slabs covering the ground. Despite its deprived circumstance, the plant had found a foothold, rooted itself in the dry crevice, and was flourishing. Later, I noticed that an air conditioning unit located directly above the plant dropped water on it throughout the day. While its surroundings were hostile, the plant received the help it needed from the water above. Growing in the Christian life can sometimes be difficult, but when we persevere, with Christ, barriers are surmountable. Our circumstances may be unfavorable and discouragement may seem like an obstacle. Yet if we press on in our relationship with the Lord, we can flourish like the lone plant. This was the experience of the Apostle Paul. Despite the severe hardships and challenges he faced, 2 Corinthians 11:23-27, he wouldn't give up. See, we can't give up, saints. No matter what we're going through, we cannot give up. He said, I take hold of that for which Christ Jesus took hold of me, he wrote. I press on toward the goal to win the prize, Philippians 3:12-14. Paul realized he could do all things through the Lord who strengthened. So we press on with the help of one who gives us strength. See, apart from Christ, we can't do nothing. But as we stay connected to the vine, we're the branches. Jesus is the vine. So we've got to stay connected. This is a day that you've made, Father, and this is a prayer. Thank you that you will be near in whatever I face today. Amen. God is with us whatever we face. God provides the strength we need to persevere and grow. Today's reading contains the most personal statement Paul makes in his letters. In the preceding verses, he unpacks his Jewish heritage, religious training, and great zeal for Judaism. All right, I'm not going to read all that. No. All right, praise the Lord. You know, I don't know why. I just felt like sharing this with you. You know those flowers I got for my birthday? The rest died, but you know what I did? I changed the water and added a little more sugar, and look at them. I said, Lord, I pray they stay till Friday. I love them. They smell good. They brighten up your day. I just wish the flowers would stay alive longer, but I just felt like telling that. I thought that was maybe because it was talking about that plant, you know. All right. Praise the Lord. All right, let's get into this. Now, I've got a word I want to share with you. It's really not funny, Lord. I shouldn't be laughing. Sorry. Forgive me, Lord. Because the reason I'm laughing is, and it's not because of what God's given me to do. I'm laughing because, you know, he speaks to us. He's not like what we're hearing. You know, that's why I said we kind of test it, make sure what we're listening to lines up with the Word of God. Because he tells me something totally opposite. You know, because, you know, he don't give me this, oh, everything's going to be great. You know, these people that give these messages about, oh, I see heaven. And they get all this, these angels and everything's so pretty. And these blessing messages. And me, I get, you know, Daniel and I say God keeps kicking our butt. I mean, I'm being serious. He's putting Daniel and I through trials, and we keep going through trials. And we're like, God, is it ever going to end? You know, so that's what I'm laughing at, because, you know, they're speaking something totally opposite. And I know it's not God, because that's not what God is telling me. He's not giving me these blessing type of messages. It's not like that. All right, let me share something with you here real quick, and then I'm going to tell you what God said. This all runs together. That's why I said you need to be careful what you are listening to. I got this word of Elijah list. Now, I told you before, Elijah list does have a lot of words that God speaks through, okay? And I love Elijah list because God uses certain ones to speak to me, and I've read them to you. That's why I tell you, let the Holy Spirit give you wisdom and insight what's of him. So, Father, we pray right now for more of your wisdom, discernment, Lord, what's of you and what's not, Lord. Keep it away from us, Lord. We don't want to believe a lie, Lord. We pray for your wisdom and discernment in Jesus' name. Now, I want to read you some things because I have read you a few here. I read this lady's word she spoke about up on Elijah list. And let me see if I can find what the title was first. I can tell you. I don't want to give out her name. I try not to do that because I don't feel God wants me to do that. Let me see if I can find it. Hold on 1 minute. Uh, I'm looking for. I just read it yesterday. Okay, here it is. A mighty prophetic generation will emerge. Okay, and I do believe God is getting ready to use people in these last days. Okay, she says a mighty prophetic generation will emerge. Okay, I'm going to read to you what I wrote, and some of what she said here. All right. I told her my name is Dawn Ryan. I live in Florida. I believe I've read some of your other spoken words that God has used to speak to me, I said. The Holy Spirit is our teacher, and he wants us to take what we're listening and test it. There have been other messages off Elijah's list that do not agree in my spirit, I was telling her. I agree with you that a mighty prophetic generation will emerge. I believe there's going to be those that know the Lord. Okay. I have to disagree with you and bring something to your attention. The Bible declares wounds from our friend can be trusted in the book of Proverbs, I believe. I love you and Jesus tell you what the Bible says. And see, we're to test it. God wants us to do that. Okay? She said here, she was talking about there's going to be many prophetic voices. Okay? If you read in Matthew 24:11-13, it says, many false prophets will rise up and deceive many. All right. So she said a mighty prophetic generation. I don't believe there's going to be many prophets that are speaking from the Lord in these last days. Okay. Because he says here, many false prophets will rise up and deceive many. And because lawlessness will abound, the love of many will grow cold. But he who endures to the end shall be saved. I said, you said this. Just as I spoke through Samuel, she was talking through Samuel, many will become my voice to this generation, she was saying. And I said, let me finish what she said. She said, they have been marked for a young age and they will soon recognize my voice. Some have been called to be prophets in the nation. I said, sister, there were no other Samuels, Joseph, Moses, Esther. I agree with you about they're going to be prophets to the nations, because that is one thing I've asked God for. So I believe, I confirm that. Now, I don't say that probably, I say that humbly, because that is what I pray for. You know, so that's where I'm telling you, you need to test it, make sure it lines up. I don't believe there's going to be many prophetic voices of the Lord speaking, because down here she says this. She said, there will not be many speaking truth in these last days. They will be speaking lies and deceive the body of Christ. The true prophets will be like you said here. She said this, and I agree with her. She said they will be so fine-tuned to the Holy Spirit because they spend time with Jesus and know his word. And I believe that. There will be those that are spending time with the Lord that the Holy Spirit is going to speak through. But then I believe that that's not going to be a ton of people. I don't believe that. You know, and I believe not everyone's going to be able to do signs, wonders, and miracles. Because look at, there were 12 disciples. Many of them walked away. If you look at that, we read that. I forget where it's at. But they all turned away. They couldn't do what Jesus was asking them to do. And he said to Peter, do you want to turn away too? And he said, where else can we go, Lord? You hold the words of eternal life. So I don't believe there's going to be many that everyone's going to be able to do that. I don't believe that. Because the Holy Spirit showed me that. Because if that was so, everybody would be doing this. And they don't want to do it. They don't want to hear this type of teaching because it's truth. We don't want to hear. We want to have our ears tickled. I just felt like bringing that to your attention. That's why it's so important that you test what you're listening to, what you're reading. Where you're going to church, test it. I'm not saying every church is, but there are a lot of lukewarm churches out there. And they're after your money. They want you to give a gift. And then they're preaching things, and you're like, what are you talking about? It doesn't line up with the Word of God, all right? Now, I want to share something with you, because I'm just going to read this to you. You know, I'm not some gloom and doom preacher, okay? I don't get on here and just give you gloom and doom. I give you what the Holy Spirit is putting in my heart. No, I'm not perfect. I may not say everything right, but my heart is right. I want to hear the Lord speak. I spent a lot of time with God. I mean, right now, this is what God has called me to do, to wait on. He's going to open doors. So I spend time with the Lord, and when he says something to me, I'll get down, I'll write it, and see what he's saying to me. And, you know, and things may not have happened right this minute. That doesn't mean they're not coming. It just means God's got a timing. He's showing me more that, you know, every time I think he's about to do something, we're waiting longer. Here we are in 2018. I'm like, God, where is this? We're still waiting. I thought it was already coming. We're here in 2018. And we're waiting. And others are waiting, too. They've said, oh, the door is coming back. I'm going to tell you right now, Jesus ain't coming back till he's ready to come back. You know, we're not going to make him come back any faster. And it doesn't mean we're not going to go through anything either. He talked about you're going to hear wars, rumors of war, pests, earthquakes. But the end is not yet. So I don't know where everyone's getting. They're packing up their bags, getting ready to leave. Nowhere does it say that we're going home yet. I believe we're going to watch and wait. Because why is it saying in the Bible, pray that you're worthy to escape. We're going to get to watch. You know, I believe we're going to be watching. Just like Daniel and I are waiting, I believe we're going to be waiting. I really believe that's why God's teaching Daniel and I even how to wait. And I got to be honest, we've been sitting here over 25 years. And I'm like, God, I don't want to wait anymore. We go to the grocery store and there's a line, I don't want to wait. And part of it could be my brain injury and I get impatient and I don't want to wait. And I get stressed and things that we're dealing here at the house still, you know, but and God is the one that helps us. He gets, praise God. I give God all the praise, honor, and glory. But I got to share this with you. You know, I completed this. Yeah, I'm going to share this with you because I'm going to read it to you. Yesterday afternoon, you know, he didn't speak to me. And that's the way he does. There are days where he won't say nothing. Then all of a sudden, he'll say something. All right? Well, at 1:15 p.m., at 1:15 p.m. on January 1st, which was yesterday, I was talking to God and just saying to him, everyone has a good blessing messages for 2018. You know, everybody does. They give words saying, oh, what's going to happen in 2018? Saying, oh, this is the year for this, this is for that. All right. And I said to him, you haven't said anything to me. That's what I said to him. I said, Lord, is there anything you want to say to me? And you know what he said to me? I was like, I'm going to tell you, this is what he said to me. He didn't give me no blessing message, saints. This is what he said. I heard the Holy Spirit say, the winnowing fork is in his hand and he's getting ready to thresh the floor. I was like, wow. And I titled this, my winnowing fork is in my hand and I'm getting ready to clear my threshing floor. That's what he said to me. He didn't give me no blessings for 2018. You know, just the other day, if you remember, I gave this word. Let me see if I can pull. I gave this word, hard days are ahead of you, my children, in 2018. Now, I'm not giving you this prosperous message that America's going to be blessed and we're going to have everything. No, that's not the message. And I asked God. I said, God, what are you wanting to say to your people? And I'm not kidding. This is what I heard him say. I'll read it again. He said to me, the winning fork is in his hand. He's getting ready to thresh the floor. I said, I don't get a blessing message for 2018. Instead, I get God is getting ready to clear his threshing floor. Judgment is at the heels of the nations. And then he gave me scriptures. I'm going to share this with you. I mean, I studied for like 2 hours. Matthew 25:31-33. The Son of Man will judge in the nations. When the Son of Man comes in his glory and all the holy angels with him, then he will sit on the throne of his glory. Verse 32, all the nations will be gathered before him and he will separate them one from another as a shepherd divides his sheep from the goats. And he will set the sheep on his right, but the goats on the left. I wanted to know if there were any synonyms for the word thresh. You know, the Holy Spirit, it's been giving me more revelation and knowledge. I've noticed that. I went and looked up a synonym for the word thresh. You know what I found? I found the word shake. Shake and the word tremble. All right? This is not a time to ignore what God is saying, pretending like he's not speaking. Remember, the Bible talks about those that refused God a long time ago when he spoke what happened? to all of them. We've read this. Like I said, I feel like a broken record. I keep saying over and over. But that's what a prophetic servant is, the word of warn. Word of warn was coming. It's coming. But it's taking its time. God is warning us because he loves us. He's warned our nation. I've sent letters to President Donald Trump. I've sent him to all these emails and people warning them what is coming. And nobody wants to listen. The church doesn't want to listen. We don't want to listen to true prophetic sermons. No, we want to hear messages that tickle our ears. How is that going to help us in the days ahead? That ain't going to help us. I'm telling you right now, if we don't wake up, God's going to wake us up. This is serious. God means business. You know, I see the way God disciplines Daniel and I. And I know if God is doing it to us, he's going to do it to you too. God is not a respecter of persons. Do you hear me? God loves you enough to tell you the truth. And I'm telling you right now, if you don't listen up, he's going to shake you. He's going to do whatever it takes. He's going to break you. He's going to do. I'm telling you right now, it's coming, saints. So if you are not ready, you better get ready. All right, this is what he said. All right, I'll read this scripture. I'm going to keep reading it. Hebrews 12, 25 through 29. A kingdom that cannot be shaken. See that you do not refuse him who is speaking. See, they refused him back then. He's using prophetic servants, but you're not listening. You're ignoring his servants that God has chosen to speak to you. See that you do not refuse him who is speaking. For if they did not escape when they refused him who warned them on earth, much less will we escape if we reject him who warns us from heaven. Verse 26, at that time his voice shook the earth. But now he has promised, yet once more I will shake not only the earth, but also the heavens. This phrase, yet once more, indicates the removal of things that are shaken, that is, things that have been made, in order that the things that cannot be shaken may remain. Therefore, let us be grateful for receiving a kingdom that cannot be shaken, and thus let us offer to God acceptable worship with reverence and awe, for God is a consuming fire. Now, I've told you, God is getting ready to discipline the body. He just brought this to my attention again. All right, I want to read you something. Another word from Elijah list. Real quick, I'm not going to share the whole thing. I'm just going to read something here. Okay, this person, remember I told you we have to be careful what we're listening to. She's talking about that. Now, this may be true for in a later day, but it's not yet. She's saying she had a dream where the Lord showed me a baptism of fire deeper than ever before. And she's saying that this baptism, that the church, it's happening right now, is what she's saying. She said, here, let me see if I can find it. There's a fresh baptism of fire. The fire of his presence and his love that has begun in the church. Well, I'm here to tell you it hasn't happened yet. There's got to be a purging and a cleansing first. We have not seen the church on fire and all. That hasn't happened. Because right now there are things going on in the church that we're not saying nothing about. And God has to purge the church. He's got to cleanse the church and get us ready for what's coming. So that he can use us. He can't use the church when the church is a mess right now. All right? So I wanted to emphasize that, you know, because that's why I said it's very important that you read what you're hearing. Now, I'm not saying God didn't speak to her, that message to her, because it may be something afterward that's coming. But it's not yet. We're not seeing that yet in the church. All right. I want to read you this Bible scripture and then share with you what the Holy Spirit was showing me. All right. I'm reading from the Contemporary English Versions about the weeds among the wheat. He gave me that. Matthew 13, if you've got a Bible and you want to turn to it or you want to go grab it, write down scriptures. Matthew 13, 24 through 30. Weeds among the wheat. Verse 24. Jesus then told them this story. The kingdom of heaven is like what happened when a farmer scattered good seed in a field. But while everyone was sleeping, an enemy came and scattered weed seeds in the field and then left. Verse 26. When the plants came up and began to ripen, the farmer's servants could see the weeds. Verse 27, the servants came and asked, "Sir, didn't you scatter good seed in your field? Where did these weeds come from?" Verse 28, an enemy did this, he replied. His servants then asked, "Do you want us to go out and pull up the weeds?" Verse 29, no, he answered. "You might also pull up the wheat. Leave the weeds alone until harvest time. Then I'll tell my workers to gather the weeds and tie them up and burn them. But I'll have them store the wheat in my barn." I believe this has to do with, you know, those that are walking with God are going to go to heaven. And those that not are going to be burned up in the end. But he was showing me this. There is a shaking that is coming very soon. The Lord will protect his children. He was showing me the wheat, but not those of the world, which is the weeds. He'll protect us children. We're the wheat, but the weeds, he will not protect them. They're the world. He showed me one of the big reasons that farmers keep their animals inside is to protect them from the environment. And God was showing me, you know, God's kept Daniel and I safe, and I know other Christians, you know, if you notice, look at all the violence things that are happening on the news. He's keeping you and I safe. When you're walking with the Lord, he keeps you safe and protected. And he'll do the same for all of us if we're staying close to the Lord in these last days. He will lead us. He will guide us. All right? And I believe that's what he's going to do. He's going to protect and watch over us. The Lord will keep you and I safe if we are abiding in him. Remember, apart from him, we can do nothing. We have to be seeking God daily for our lives, praying for our families and children, asking the Lord, should I go here or there? Not making our own plans. And I've said that over and over. People are making plans. Stop making your own plans because God's about to change that. Our world's getting more dangerous by the minute. Okay? And I'm asking God to keep us all safe. And I have a prayer. Father, keep your children safe in this hour, I pray. I'm going to read you something. I'm going to read you a prayer by Jesus. And then I'm going to talk to you what the Lord said to me. You know, the Holy Spirit's awesome. He's been speaking to me. He's so good. All right. It's a long scripture. If you have a Bible or you want to write it down, John 17, 6 through 26. That's John 17, 6 through 26. Jesus prays for his disciples. I didn't read the part where he prayed for himself, but he prays for his disciples, and then he prays for all people, all believers. So this is where he prays for disciples. I have manifested your name to the men whom you have given me out of the world. They were yours. You gave them to me, and they have kept your word. Now, verse 7, they have known that all things which you have given me are from you. Verse 8, for I have given to them the words which you have given me, and they have received them. And they have known surely that I came forth from you. And they have believed that you sent me. Verse 9, I pray for them. I do not pray for the world, but for those whom you have given me. For they are yours, verse 10, and all mine are yours, and yours are mine, and I am glorified in them. Verse 11, now I am no longer in the world, but these are in the world, and I come to you. Holy Father, keep through your name those whom you have given me, and that they may be one as we are. Verse 12, while I was with them in the world, I kept them in your name. Those whom you gave me, I kept. And none of them is lost except the son of perdition, that the scripture might be filled. But now I come to you, verse 13, and these things I speak in the world, that they may have my joy fulfilled in themselves. Verse 14, I've given them your word, and the world has hated them because they are not of the world. See, we're not to be of the world, just as I am not of the world. Verse 15, I do not pray that you should take them out of the world, but that you should keep them from the evil one. See, God is going to keep us and protect us from the evil one. Verse 16, they are not of the world, just as I'm not of the world. Sanctify them by your truth. Your word is truth. Verse 18, as you sent me into the world, I also have sent them into the world. Verse 19, and for their sakes I sanctify myself, and they also may be sanctified by the truth. Now I want to talk to you about the believers. He says, Jesus prays for all believers. I do not pray for these alone, he says, but also for those who will believe in me through their word. That's you. God is praying for us, okay? He says, verse 21, that they all may be one as you, Father, are in me and I in you, that they also may be one in us, that the world may believe that you sent me. Verse 22, and the glory which you gave me, I have given them, that they may be one just as we are one. 23, I in them and you in me, that they may be made perfect in one, and that the world may know that you have sent me and have loved them as you have loved me. Verse 24. Father, I desire that they also whom you gave me may be with me where I am, that they may behold my glory which you have given me, for you loved me before the foundation of the world. O righteous Father, verse 25. The world has not known you, but I've known you, and these have known that you sent me, and I have declared to them your name, and will declare it, that the love with which you love me may be in them, and I in them. Now, like I said, Jesus prayed for the disciples and for you and I, because he says here, I do not pray for them alone, but also for those who will believe in me through the word. And he said up there that I don't wish that you take them out of the world, he said, but to pray for them because they're still in the world. And the Holy Spirit was telling me this. This is a very powerful prayer, saints, that Jesus prayed, and he said this to me. You need to be praying this in your homes, he said, and pastors in your church daily, I said. Something my spirit was telling me that. We need to be praying this prayer in our homes. So you need to get this prayer written down. We need to be praying it in our homes daily, and that goes for me, and that's something God was saying to me. We need to pray it daily, and pastors, in your churches, you need to be praying for God's protection and covering. Because we've seen people come in churches and shoot people. Alright? These are not safe times. These are trying days that are ahead of us, okay? Alright? And I want to mention this because the Lord showed me this. This headline from Fox News I received yesterday in my inbox. Okay. Now, I don't read news. That's not something I do. But I read enough of it so I can share it with you and so that I know what's going on. I said, I hardly look at news because it depresses me. We have to stay encouraged in the Lord. Okay. And I read this. New Jersey teen in custody after allegedly killing his parents, two others in family home on a New Year's Eve. And I said, God, I couldn't believe it. It just upset me. And this is what's happening. This is what's happening with the children. They're turning on their parents. Do you hear what I'm saying? This is what's going on right now. And it's going to get worse. It's not going to get any better, I'm going to tell you right now. It's going to get worse. And that's why we can't be looking at that all the time and reading all that. You know, yes, we need to know what's going on, but he was showing me this. Okay, we need to stay encouraged, saints. That's why you see your brother or sister down, lift them up, encourage them. But remember that scripture in Philippians 4:8. Meditate on these things. Finally, brethren, whatever things are true, whatever things are noble, whatever things are just, and whatever things are pure, whatever things are lovely, whatever things are of good report, if there is any virtue and if there's anything praiseworthy, meditate on these things. See, we need to meditate on those things. Now, I'm not saying we're to have our eyes closed, everything, which I'm saying, no, we're not. Okay? Do not be reading this type of news before bedtime. That's what I said. Don't be reading that before you're going to bed. The enemy will try to put dreams in your head and cause fear. You need to be applying the blood over your door, over your doorpost at night when you go to bed. Not literally, but applying the blood. I pray over my door. Pray over your front door before you go to bed. Ask the angels to watch over you. You pray over your family and your children before they leave the house. I always do before I sleep. I pray over the room, airways, my mind. Daniel and I say a prayer before bed. We now have been playing soft worship with no lyrics. I'm telling you, saints, there's something about that. When I'm praying, it's like it clears everything. And it's so restful. I never did that, really. Well, I mean, I have done it, but not every night. You know, and Daniel and I still are fasting meals throughout the day, at different times. Breakfast, a lot of time, we'll skip breakfast and not eat breakfast. You know, and I just think it helps that we're praying more and playing that Christian music. I really believe it cleans out the air, too. I said, now when it comes to news, I look at just enough to report it to you and so I know what is happening. I know people on YouTube, that is all they do. People on YouTube, that's all they do. And that's why they got all these subscribers, not me. I don't do that. That's not my calling. I mean, I share some news, but I mostly give teachings, prophetic words, what the Holy Spirit is saying to me. Now, I said, Alex Jones is one. He probably has how many guns and sleeps with them. I mean, he's on all the time. He's nervous about what's going on. But see, if we know the Lord and we're walking with God, we don't have to worry, saints. I'm going to tell you right now, having a gun, having a bunch of food, is not what's going to protect you and I in the later days. Jesus is going to protect us. I'm going to tell you right now, you got to have Jesus. The cloud, remember the Israelites, the cloud protected them day and night. Jesus will protect us. I believe when it's time for me to go, I'm going to go. That's just what I believe. I mean, if we all had guns, we'd be shooting one another. I don't believe God wants us to have guns. Was it Peter to cut off the ear? And he told him, put the sword back. So that's my opinion. I know different people have different opinions about it. But that is what I feel in my spirit. I said, we cannot trust in our own means of sustaining ourselves. We have to trust God. If we could take care of ourselves, we would not need God. Why would we need him? If you and I could take care of ourselves. I don't know about you, but I need God the second minute. Our day. I need God all the time. He's not a crutch, but he's what's going to be there to help you and I. He's our strength. He's our life. He's what helps me get. I couldn't go on without him. I don't even know how I lived all those years without him. He's what helps us, saints. So we've got to be abiding in the Lord. Here's another scripture you can write down. John 15:4-8. Abide in me and I in you, as a branch can not bear fruit of itself. See, we can't do anything without the Lord. We need God in our life. Unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. See, I know people try and do all this. They're doing this, doing that. You can't do it. You've got to have the Lord's help on your side. You've got to be asking him for direction, wisdom. You know, even our nation, we're saying, oh, we can conquer our enemies. Don't mess with us, Kim Jong-un. You know, things are different. We're not going to do anything on our own. I'm going to tell you right now. President Donald Trump, we love you. But we can't do it on our own. We got to stay humble and meek before our God. We need God to help us. We need God to help America. Because I'm going to tell you right now, the times have changed. And we can't do it on our own. We need to pray for President Donald Trump. He's getting attacked with a new world order. You pray that he becomes all that God wants him to be. I believe God placed him in office for such a time as this so that we can preach the gospel. Because if not, the enemy would shut us up. All right. He abides in me and I in him bears much fruit, for without me you can do nothing. Verse 6, if anyone does not abide in me, he is cast out as a branch and is withered, and they gather them and throw them into the fire, and they are burned. You see, that's what's going to happen in the end. Remember, we talked about the weeds. They're going to be gathered and burned. Verse 7, if you abide in me, and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire, and it shall be done for you. Verse 8, and this my Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit, so that you will be my disciples. All right, I've got a poem now I want to read you. Abide in the Lord. As you abide in me and I abide in you, my promises are faithful too. Ask anything according to my will. Relax, my child. Just be still. I'm the answer to all your prayers. Seek me, for I do care. Take time to kneel before me and pray. Not a lot of words I say, but listen for my still, small voice. See, God's speaking. If we will take the time to listen. But what's going on is we're so busy going here, going there. We don't spend any time with God. Now, I'm not telling you to do what I'm doing. This is what God's called me to do. You need to do what God's called you to do. You need to pray and ask God, God, what is your will for my life? What is it you want me to do? He'll show you. Do not make a fuss. Remember, I am in no rush. That's right. God is in no rush. He takes his time. Oh, does he take his time? My timing is not your own, so don't get restless and call a friend on the phone. I'm here and heard your faintest cry. Let me wipe your tears all dry. Don't give up or quit. Get angry, upset, or have a fit. Trust me to work this out. It will happen in my time, not yours. So do not doubt. I never lie, but I make you wait. Teaching you to slow down. I'm never late. That's right. God teaches us to slow down. Your times are in my hand, and my thoughts of you are countless as the sand. Be not weary and fret. Get tired and impatient. Press on and finish the race. We will soon see Jesus face to face. Amen. And I wrote that back in 2013. Psalm 139, 17 through 18. How precious to me are your thoughts, God. How vast is the sum of them. Were I to count them, they would outnumber the grains of sand. When I awake, I'm still with you. Praise the Lord. Alrighty. Then he said this to me. It is time for your flesh to die. Now, we've talked about that before. We've got to take up our cross and follow Christ in these last days. But I heard him say this, and I know we don't want to hear this. But that's what he said. It's time for your flesh to die. And then he said this. If it's not dead yet, it's going to be. See, if we don't want to listen to God, he's going to do it. He's going to do it. It ain't going to be fun. It's going to be very painful. I see people hurting, crying. God wants us to die to our flesh. I'm not talking about a physical death. Although many will die a physical death. No, I'm talking about a spiritual death. For some of you, I'm speaking way over your head, and you have no idea what I'm talking about. There are those, I know, when I'm talking about dying to the flesh, they're like, what are you talking about? I'm talking over their head. This is not for you. This is for those that God wants it for, that God is speaking to. God wants you and I to die to the things of this world, all right? He wants to die to our flesh. My husband, and we got to have a little lightheartedness here. My husband always cracks jokes to make our trials lighthearted. That's one thing about Daniel. Daniel is always trying to make me laugh. And maybe that's one of the reasons we're together too, because he always, we're opposites. Opposites are different. I'm always serious, and Daniel's always like the clown. He's laughing, and it makes me laugh. But I need to light me up, help me. He's there to help me when I get stressed. And I said he should have been a comedian. He always makes me laugh when he knows I'm stressed. He has said to me many of times from some movie, because he always quotes lines from different actors. He says to me, just let the flesh die. Let it die. And it's like he says it to me not all the time, but he has said that in the past to me. Just let the flesh die. Let it die. Daniel's like that. The Holy Spirit will have him say something from a movie. And it's times, maybe I don't want to hear it, but maybe I need to hear it. All right. John 12:24-25 says, "It is a fact that a grain of wheat must fall to the ground and die before it can grow and produce much more wheat. If it never dies, it will never be more than a single seed." Verse 25, "Whoever loves the life they have now will lose it." See, we can't be loving our life. "But whoever is willing to give up their life in this world will keep it." So you got to be willing to die to this world, give up your life to the Lord. "They will have eternal life," he said. "Are you ready to put your flesh to death? Those who crucify their flesh will live forevermore with Jesus in heaven." Remember Matthew 16:24-26. "Then Jesus said to his disciples, 'If anyone desires to come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me.'" See, if you're going to follow Christ, you can't just pray a sinner's prayer and then just walk away and do what you want to do. No. If you're going to follow Christ, you got to take up your cross. And you got to be willing to do whatever he's asking you to do. You know, remember some of those, let me see if I got that scripture in here. Well, no, I don't have them. Remember some of them, they made excuses. Said, "Lord, let me first go bury my mother or my father." They had all these excuses. "Then I'll follow you." No, we can't be making up excuses. Stop making up excuses. If God is asking you to do it, you need to do it now. You don't need to keep making up excuses and saying, "Oh, we'll do it later." No, now. God is asking you to do it now. All right? Verse 25, "For whoever desires to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. For what profit is to a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? Or what will a man give in exchange for a soul? We must die to self." I've told you this many times, you cannot love the world and God. Yes, we live in this world, but you and I are not of it. 1 John 2:15-17. "Do not love the world. Do not love the world or the things in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him." Verse 16, "For all that is in the world, the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life is not of the Father, but is of the world. And the world is passing away." See, our world is passing away. "And the lust of it, but he who does the will of God abides forever." See, we've got to be doing God's will in these last days. If we're going to abide forever, we've got to be doing God's will. Just like money, we have to use money while we are on the earth. Because everything costs money except your eternal salvation. That is a free gift. Jesus died freely for you and me so we could live with him eternally in heaven. See, everything in life costs money. The only thing that doesn't is giving your heart and life to Jesus. All right? Well, you said the sinner's prayer. If you haven't said it yet, call him now. Everyone who calls upon the name of the Lord will be saved. We can't love money more than God. Money in itself is not evil. And I've said this before. Money in itself is not evil. It is the love of money. Now, if you love money and you love material things, then yes, that's not right. We're to love God. God is to be our first love. We're to love him above everything else. You know, there's a very fine line. We've got to make sure we keep everything in perspective. And that goes for me in the future. Because I know God's going to bless us. And I said, "Lord, keep us humble and meek. Keep you first and all. He's everything. Without Christ, I'm nothing. I already know that. Without the Lord, I'm nothing." 1 Timothy 6:10, "For the love of money is the root of all kinds of evil, for which some have strayed from the faith in their greediness." See, it says, "For the love of money is the root of all kinds of evil, for which some have strayed from the faith in their greediness and pierced themselves through many sorrows." Remember in 2015, I spoke a prophetic word about layoffs that are coming. Remember, I've spoken that. You can go on our YouTube website and listen to that. I said many ISINs are going to be laid off of work in 2018. I'm not saying that to you to be mean. No, I'm telling you what is coming, so you quit listening to preaching that tickles your ears. I better say it again. All right. Remember, in 2015, you can go on our YouTube website. I wrote a word about how I see layoffs are coming. Many, I sense, are going to be laid off of work in 2018. I'm not saying that to be mean. No, I'm telling you what is coming, so you quit listening to preaching that tickles your ears. And that's what they're doing. They're tickling your ears. They're wanting your money. Stop giving your hard-earned money to those that are not even doing what the gospel says. Okay? They're not even preaching the gospel, bringing others to Christ. No, they're preaching out of their own mindsets. Start giving your hard-earned money to those that God is going to use in these final days. All right? Now, I'm not saying just give your money to us. There are other ministries that are coming up on the scene. I truly believe it. There's going to be a new wave of leadership. God's getting ready to use new people in these last days. And, you know, if there's anyone listening that would like to help out a ministry, you know, I got to tell you something. I'm getting ready now. I don't know how to do this. Dan's going to help me. It's called a Patreon page. Have you heard of that? Now, you can actually give a dollar on there. I'm working on setting that up, saying, because I know there are people that if you can give even $1 a month, you know, it's not about money, how much you get, right? You can give $1 a month. I'm working on that. Then you got this thing set up. I saw this. I saw this on somebody else's. They got $20 a month, and they'll give you 20 minutes. You can talk to them once a month on the phone. I'm thinking, well, I could pray with people, but you know what happens as God starts doing that? I'll get so busy, I'll have to be talking on the phone. I don't have time for that. I give God the glory. I was laughing because I thought, you know, I don't want to do that. I'm not into that, okay? I'm into doing God's will. But I'm working on setting up that Patreon page, all right? But if you want to help us anyway, if you'd like to send a gift through PayPal now, it comes directly to us. I'll give you that email because people have asked, heartfeltcorner10@gmail.com. HeartfeltCorner10@gmail.com. You can send a love offering through there or come directly to us. If you want to give a gift to Daniel, specify Daniel and Donna, right? And then we'll know that belongs to us because we don't make anything. We don't make a lot right now. We're in our Lord. All right, now if you want to send a gift in the mail, you can Don's Heartfelt Corner, P.O. Box 161273, Altamont Springs, Florida 32716. The website, www.donsheartfeltcorner.org. You can also partner with us. We are a 501c3 ministry. If you would like a receipt, I'll send it out to you. All the information is listed on each link that I place up. So if you want to send me a prayer request, or you want to send a letter of encouragement, I love your words, encourages me to do these videos. Send to heartfeltcorner10@gmail.com. That's the same email as the PayPal. Got all these websites, emails, so I can't remember them all. So if you want to write us there, or you can send on Facebook or YouTube, don't put anywhere else. If I don't respond back, it's because I'm busy. I'm getting to get busy. I'm like, oh, God, help me. I know I'm doing everything. Gang does on the backside. But, all right, that's all I'm going to say right now with that. All right, let's get back to this here. The bottom, Lord showed me this too. The bottom of the market is about to drop out. Prepare now, says the Lord, for hard days. The days ahead will be very hard. It will not be easy. And remember, I just spoke that word just the other day on 12/31, just before the new year. Hard days are ahead of you, my children, in 2018. All right? I know people don't want to hear it, but I'm not going to lie to you. I'm not going to lie to you and tell you what you want to hear. No, I'm going to tell you the truth. Warning, a great big shaking is coming. I say it again, warning, a great big shaking is coming. And I've said that over and over. A great big shaking is coming. Prepare for hard days, says the Lord. Now, I'm going to try to see how many of these videos I can list. Remember, I just wrote that word that you can go listen to, and also tell my people. Remember he said, tell my people, I'm about to wake them up. I was like, wow. That was on 12/27. Then, remember he gave me that dream of California, the Hollywood movie, back in November 14th. Now, I'm telling you right now, I believe these dreams will happen. I don't know when, but I believe there is something. God's showing me these things. I believe that with all my heart. All right? Remember, now, remember this. On 12-5, I spoke about a vision. Remember that? A vision of, excuse me, a vision of a baby being shaken that was asleep. Then I looked at baby being shaken. I got this. What is shaken baby syndrome? It's providing one definition of shaken baby syndrome, also called shaken impact syndrome. It's revolt from violent shaking. And God showed me that's what he's about to do to the church. He's going to go like this. He's going to shake us up, saints. I mean, this is serious. I remember I talked about that guy, too, from Australia. He God showed him this. He said that his left shoulder shook me about 10 times. He didn't know that was the Holy Spirit, what it was. And he asked God for some confirmation, got a scripture. As Exodus 3:2, it says this, there the angel of the Lord appeared to him later, and he read Psalm 108 in the first two paragraphs. It says, wake up. The Lord put together prophetically saying, wake up. There's a great shaking coming. He was praying in the spirit last night, and I saw the ground breaking up and shaking, and this black, thick ooze coming out of the cracked surface. I'm telling you, God's going to do something. I don't know exactly what it is or if it's going to be more than one thing. But it's coming. I'm going to tell you right now. God is trying to wake us up. And you're seeing all the earthquakes and volcanoes waking up. I mean, can we see the ring of fire? Seriously. We're going to see some things happen. What about an EMP headed our way? I did that back in 2015. We can't trust our enemies. Are they going to send missiles to us? I'm going to tell you right now. We as a nation better get strong in the Lord. We got to be built on the rock, Christ Jesus, or we're not going to be able to handle it. What's coming our way? Now, I placed up, I'm not going to read it, I don't think today, but remember, I did on 12:31. This gentleman from Jeff Byerly did a word on vision and word from the Lord concerning the dollar bill and destruction. I've placed a link up there for you to look at, so go and take a look at that. And I've given you the website now, you know, Dutch Sense talks about the earthquakes, what's happening on the West Coast. Remember, I woke up 3 a.m. and God told me, warn the people back in May about an earthquake hitting on the West Coast. All right. And what about the fires? He told me back in July. We saw that happen. All right. So we're going to see something. I know we are, saints. I'm not going to read all of this. You can take a look at these videos. I'll let you do that. All right. I think that's everything. Let's play the song. You know, I always play it. I love this song. We'll play it real quick, and then we'll pray. We'll pray for our nation, pray for all of us before we get ready to leave. All right. I've decided to follow Jesus. I've prayed this every time. Make that decision today. Make the decision to follow Jesus. Here we go.
I have decided to follow Jesus.
Amen. Make the decision.
I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back.
There's no turning back.
No turning back. The world behind me, the cross before. Yes, the world behind me, the cross. With me, still I will follow.
That is our declaration. I love playing that because that's letting you know we're going to follow Jesus no matter what we're going to go through. There's no turning back. And that means even if you got to go alone, there's no turning back. We're going to follow Jesus until the finish. We're running a race, saints. There's no giving up. All right. Let's pray real quick before we leave. Father, I pray for all of us that's on here today, Lord. Father, I apply the blood over each one of us, Lord. Give your angels charge over us wherever we're to go, to the right or to the left, Lord. No weapon formed against us shall prosper. We put the full armor on today, Lord. We thank you, Lord, that your angels are watching over us, Lord. We don't need to worry or be afraid of what going to happen tomorrow, Lord. Our hope and trust is in you one day at a time, Lord. Father, we pray for America. We lift up our nation right now. We pray for President Donald Trump, Lord. We pray that you would give him wisdom and direction for our nation in the days ahead, Lord. We pray, oh God, that we turn our hearts back to you. We pray for a mighty revival, Lord, to sweep across our nation like never before, Lord. We want to see your power and anointing, Lord. Touch this nation, Lord. Touch your people that don't even know you, Lord. There are those that are blinded, Lord. Help me to be quiet, Lord, because I know sometimes people are persecuting me and I want to say something. But, Lord, help all of us children to be quiet. Let our words be few, Lord, especially in these last days. We need to watch everything we say or do, Lord. So help us to know when to speak and when to be silent, Lord. I pray, oh God, that you go before us today. Bless this day. Bless everything we say or do. May you be glorified. We just love you. We praise you, Lord. We wait upon you. We continue to wait patiently, Lord. Give us patience, endurance, and strength, Lord. Help your people today, whatever they're going through, Lord, today. I ask that you would answer prayer for them. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen, amen. I want you to know we love you. We appreciate you. Keep going, saints. We have to keep going. We can't give up. You know, that's one reason why I continue to do these videos, because I know it encourages you. There are those that are waiting on God, just like Daniel and I are waiting for doors to be opened. So I know there are others that I'm speaking to. They've actually wrote me before. So I want you to be encouraged. Stay encouraged. Keep seeking, Lord. Keep praying. Keep waiting upon the Lord. God's got a time. Remember, it's his timing, not our timing. Remember, he's given that the vision, though it tarry, wait for it. It's surely come. God's got a timing. It's like we're in a doctor's office. When your name is called, it's time for you to go. We're going to see huge revival, I believe, in these last days. Keep going strong. Keep pressing down. All right. I'll talk to you soon. This is Dawn O'Brien, Prophetess Dawn O'Brien, servant of the Lord with Dawn's Heart. God bless you. Have a safe and blessed day. Is it Tuesday? Talk to you soon.